never had a Ducks in Texas. Be with my old pal David Wesley. We have a problem here, Houston. These ducks have heard how deadly we are, John.
Oh, yeah.
Take it. Oh, look at him get up behind us.
Holy moly, yeah.
This could disappear.
It could, yeah.
Here they come. Take them.
No thing.
What is that?
He said for a couple of old farts, which he's pretty mad.
Last December, my dad headed to Texas for a waterfowl weekend with longtime family friends.
I've done this before.
Of course, not your first rodeo, I know that.
No.
I was supposed to head down with him, but life got in the way.
Well, this morning was supposed to be a trip for my dad and me heading to Texas on a duck hunt. Unfortunately, about 10 days ago, my wife, Sherry, was diagnosed with some health problems. I decided it was more important for me to back out, be here for my wife, but still have my dad continue on the hunt. So even though I'm not going on the hunt, my dad and stepmom came by last night. They wanted to see Sherry, say a few prayers for her upcoming surgery, see her dad who was in town for the surgery, and we just got to spend a couple of hours together talking about the hunt, just enjoying each other's time. I gave my dad a couple of Browning shotguns to take on the hunt, as well as some Wicked Wing waterfowl gear, and just wishing him all kinds of success, tons of fun, good camaraderie on this hunt, which at the end of the day is what hunting's all about.
I haven't seen you in a while. How long's it been?
Too long.
Too long.
After arriving in Texas, my dad met up with his old friend, David Wesley. My dad and Dave have known each other for over 50 years, meeting in graduate school at Colorado State University. They've been friends ever since.
What made me turn around to look is I saw that case.
Gun case? Yeah.
And I said, John may be here.
The outdoors played a major role in their friendship that included hunting and even Dave getting my dad a job at Ducks Unlimited, a job my dad had for 17 years.
Keith is over there.
Keith is Dave's son, who currently works for Ducks Unlimited, and invited us down to hunt ducks and show us some of what DU is doing for conservation in the area.
Keeping Willie straight?
He's a tough guy to keep straight.
Keith and I were raised in the outdoors, and with our fathers being friends, the Wesleys have always felt more like extended family. Keith and I have shared a few hunting camps, most notably a father-son elk hunt in 2003.
I got something for you.
That's an XL there.
This should be an XL. It's green anyway.
Yep, XL.
Then, but I'm not through. Wait, there's more.
There's more.
There's more.
It's like Christmas.
Like Christmas.
Then we'll be on site at 5:30 and we'll make a game plan.
Don't let me forget the guns.
That wouldn't be good.
You're bang, bang.
Bang,
gotcha. All right, sleep well.
The next morning, the Wesleys and my dad headed down to meet their guides for the day.
Hi, John Schmidt.
Mr. Schmidt? Paul Grimmett.
John.
John?
And Mr. Schmidt was my dad.
Jody.
Jody, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, sir.
So you've seen some ducks around?
We don't have near the birds we should have.
Really?
We got some.
Mosquito repellent when you're duck hunting, that's a first.
See, these bugs know I'm from Mississippi. They don't mess with me.
They don't mess with you.
Good luck.
You ready to get some birds? Huh? You ready to get some birds? Oh, yes.
There's some serious shooting going on here. No misses.
There's more tiny.
Oh, yeah.
Take
these ducks have heard how deadly we are, John.
Pure Hunting is brought to you by Browning, the best there is, and by Thorogood, American manufacturer of job-fitted work and outdoor footwear since 1892. Hoyt, get serious, get Hoyt. Iota Outdoors, question every detail. Control the sound with custom-fit digital hearing protection from ESP. And these other fine companies. My dad, John Schmidt, traveled to Texas for a December duck hunt with some old friends.
Whoops! We have a problem here, Houston.
Houston.
Hey, we are in Houston.
We are in Houston, aren't we? Where are we loading? I got two boxes. I don't. You might ought to bring a third. I don't know what we need, since I've never missed a duck.
If you've never missed a shot, one box will be enough for today and tomorrow.
I got it.
Spot for the gun?
Yes, sir.
This ought to be a fun day. I've never hunted ducks in Texas, and it'll be fun to be with my old pal David Wesley, who went to graduate school together. We worked for Ducks Unlimited together, and I haven't seen him in 7 or 8 years.
What are you trying to do? See where we're going?
There's going to be some serious shooting going on here. No misses.
What's the strategy? I understand you've been seeing a lot of mallards in the afternoon.
A lot of mallards in the afternoon.
Pintails.
North Pond. Pintails, they've been flying a little bit later. But they're so savvy right now with all the hunters, it's pretty hard to get them. And you got to really be down and still.
For the pintail?
Yes, sir. Yeah. Real stealthy.
See right here, 12.
They're in trouble.
Going the wrong way.
They're ignoring us. What is this? Well, these ducks have heard how deadly we are, John.
They're just staying away.
Oh, huh? Yeah, they stand there. They're panicked.
What we got coming here?
Oh, yeah. Take it. Duke knows what to do. So the widgeon? Spoonies.
Okay.
Duke doesn't care. He'll retrieve a spoonie.
So you are both DU?
We work for Ducks Unlimited, okay. Yeah. Dave, you worked right out of graduate school, didn't you?
Originally, I started DU in 71. We had our whole staff, we had 7 people in the whole country. The whole staff could go to dinner in one car.
I started in 84, and that was the year Pete Coors was president.
Yeah.
And that was the year that we started doing habitat work in the U.S. under the Marsh program.
Yeah. And looking back at the growth in DU is pretty interesting. I look at when I started, I must be getting old.
What a job, huh?
Yeah.
That would be nice.
Here comes one.
Come on.
Give it one more time.
We never missed a duck, you know.
Oh, here we go in front. Oh no.
They all squealers, aren't they?
What are those?
Squealers.
Squealer.
Mexican squealers. It's a Mexican tree duck.
Oh,
you know that?
No, that's interesting. I've not seen those. How do they taste?
They're not bad.
Really? So they're shootable, huh?
They're shootable.
Oh, okay.
We don't normally shoot them, but hey, got them.
Straight
down. Come on.
Oh, look at him get up behind us.
Holy moly.
In Texas, my dad was into his first day of duck hunting with his longtime friend, David Wesley, and his son, Keith.
They're turning again.
Oh, yeah. Take them.
With not a lot of action in the morning, the group made a plan for the afternoon hunt.
So what's the plan this afternoon?
Carl's talking about us maybe going over here on that west unit. They're getting up and moving around small groups, but he saw good groups of mallards over here. But yeah, this morning it was a little slow, but you know, a lot of those ducks stayed high. I mean, you could hear them.
Yeah, we'd see bunches. It was like they just ignored us.
Yeah, I just educated them this morning, that's about it.
Yeah, they educated us too, somehow. Yeah. That will maybe this afternoon be even better.
I kept waiting for you to duck down because I knew I was coming right.
Yeah, I was getting down. So.
Oh, look at him get up behind us. Got one. I think he's dead.
So there's a couple.
Ducks Unlimited is the world's leader in wetlands and waterfowl conservation. Their mission is simple: habitat conservation. Thanks to decades of abiding by that single mission, Ducks Unlimited is now the world's largest and most effective private waterfowl and wetlands conservation organization, having conserved 14 million acres over the last 80 years and counting.
In general, from what I'm hearing, we have great numbers of ducks this year.
Oh yeah, the magazine.
National.
Or continentally.
Yeah, continentally, it's supposed to be a good year. Good one coming.
Here they come. Come on, boys. Hey.
There's two coming in straight out in front.
Yeah. Oh, here we go in front. Oh, no.
Oh, same.
What did he say?
He said for a couple of old farts, which he was pretty bad.
Well, she immediately went in those weeds.
All right,
shooting hours over, huh?
It's done, it's done.
All right. Okay, I'm empty.
More birds showed up for the afternoon hunt, and after nearly reaching their limit, shooting hours ended, and it was time to call it a day.
I shot at the hen.
I wouldn't mind mounting. That's a pretty mallard because he's not messed up anywhere. He's got a pretty good tail, but it's not bad.
Yeah. I don't care if you mount him.
as you can see over there, we don't have a bank anymore. And that will not be protected at all. It just could disappear.
It could, yeah.
Here they come. Take them.
Pure Hunting is brought to you by Browning Ammunition and by Browning Crossbows. Wilderness Athlete, the authority on outdoor performance. And by Fox Pro, high performance game calls. Browning Casual Sportswear, the best there is. And these other fine companies.
Be sure to check out Tenzing for their full line of packs.
From the backcountry for elk to the tree stand for whitetail, Tenzing is my pack of choice.
I travel a fair amount on some of my hunts,
and I trust Plano to keep my hunting equipment safe and protected while traveling on all of my hunts.
Yeah, so we're gonna be heading down to San Bernard National Wildlife Refuge, where there's a project we did called Caltrap Lake.
The next day in Texas, Keith Wesley wanted to take my dad and his dad Dave to see what Ducks Unlimited was doing for wetland protection and conservation in the area.
I want to introduce you to Dr. Todd Marandino.
I just said hello, I'm Dave.
And well, this is John Schmidt over here.
Hey John, Todd Marandino, good to see you.
Oh, it's Todd.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Tell me your role in this.
I am the manager of conservation programs for Ducks Unlimited for Texas, Oklahoma, and New Mexico.
Wow.
And so a lot of our work, though, is right here on the Texas coast, from Beaumont, Port Arthur, down to about Corpus Christi. Yeah. Probably the lion's share of our work is there.
Well, Todd, what I'm going to have you do is back me up.
Okay.
Dump me off.
I can do that.
And we'll head down to Caltrap.
Caltrap. So this is the Intracoastal Waterway, and our state highway department actually has like the maintenance authority on the canal. This canal, it's Intracoastal Canal, you know, goes to the whole Gulf Coast. It's a major navigation highway. Lots of stuff moves up and down it. So yeah, there's a lot of erosion and wind fetch. We'll see some of that today. So be kind of neat with that barge going by.
I'm just going to ease up in here and park it.
So yeah, this is the Caltrap Terraces. You know, they're just a series of these zigzag terraces, you know, stopping wind energy, stopping wave energy, but a lot of other benefits with it. You know, water quality, you can see the clear water behind them, you know, birds in the grass area. This project actually started in about 2011, you know, getting all the documents together, grant funding, different things like that. The terraces were built in 2014, I believe. The reason the terraces were built was to protect the interior marsh from that wind fetch and shoreline erosion. You can see the terraces are doing their job on a day like today. This afternoon and tomorrow will be even better. They're not designed to be here permanently. They're designed to be sacrificial in the sense that they stop the wind fetch, they'll trap sediment, they'll establish plants, and that in itself lets that shoreline back there to reestablish and revegetate. This is a lot of different habitat mosaic. So, you know, this Caltrap Lake is fairly shallow, 2 foot deep or so. And again, they're stacking this material, so the backside of these terraces may be 5 or 6 feet. So that's a lot of different fish habitat as well. Now you've got a lot of edge habitat, you know, the shoreline, you know, so you...
And that one of these sections right here that we did, like right here, is you can see over there where you don't have a bank anymore. It's sandy, and eventually what's gonna happen is it's gonna make its way through there, and that will not be protected at all. Then you have a serious issue with the salt water and the intrusion going into the marsh there.
And so we still have a permit, like a Corps of Engineers permit, to build the rest of the breakwater here. We just don't have the funding. It's expensive. We've got a little over a mile to build, and so we're trying to piece together some funding, different sources like that. So I think all in, all of this, like you're looking at, I mean, it was $1 million. Might have been a tad more than that, but $1 million all in. So that's why, again, you know, you start with, you know, you start with funding, right? And you keep leveraging that into different grant programs and, you know, coming up with $1 million to do the project. It just takes time. It takes time to do that. This is one of those projects you might not think, well, who's Ducks Unlimited, right?
Right.
That's not something Ducks live, but all of that marsh back there is really good duck habitat, really good water bird habitat, and the best way to protect it's right here, out here in this type of environment, which is, again, outside of our normal kind of suite of tools. If
otherwise, this could disappear.
It could, yeah.
After their day on the water with DU, it was time to squeeze in one last hunt down in South Texas.
So this morning, I think Dad and I are gonna go with Jody where we were yesterday. And John's gonna go out in the marsh to your special blind that you have.
With me.
Hey, all right.
Truth of the matter is what we end up deciding. These two are troubled together, so we're splitting them up today.
That'll work.
All right, let's do it.
Thank you.
So it's fun to come out here, have two generations that work with Ducks Unlimited to enjoy kind of the work that DU's done, and along with the private landowners. It'd been fun to have Willie here. He could have hunted with his dad, and I appreciate the fact that Willie thought about this hunting trip down here on the Texas Gulf Coast, and hopefully we can do it again in the future and Willie can join us.
They're coming in, ready? Take them.
That was some good shooting there. 12 o'clock early.
Even though I didn't make it down to Texas, my dad had the opportunity to hunt with an old friend and make some new memories in the process.
Oh, Duke knows what to do.